Good morning, dear students, and welcome to science. These days, all of us are doing a lot of work. I know it is lockdown, but still, everybody is working from home. Teachers are making PowerPoint presentations and videos sitting in front of the computer or maybe mobile, and students are downloading videos or watching laptop or, you know, some apps. So everybody is doing some sort of work. But scientifically speaking, are we really doing work? So let us find out in the lesson called as Work and Energy. Here I have placed some pictures. In these pictures, you can see the first picture that a boy is reading a book. In the second picture, you can see that a porter is carrying a load on his head. In the third picture, you can see the man is running. And in the fourth picture, you can see that that lady is doing some work on the computer. Can you tell in which of the pictures above the work has been done? If you see in the first picture, the boy is reading a book. That means he is doing some sort of mental work. In the second picture, the porter carrying a load on his head, that means he is doing some physical work. In the third picture, the person is running, that means he is using his energy. And so it is a type of a physical work. Whereas this lady sitting in front of the computer is using her brain, that means she is doing the mental work. Now, from scientific point of view, when do we say that the work is done? Generally, any mental or physical activity is referred to as work. When we walk or run, the energy in our body is used to do necessary work. So we say that when a boy is studying or reading a book and the lady who is sitting in front of the computer is doing some work, this type of work is called as mental work. In physics or in science, we deal with physical work. So work has special meaning in physics. Now when we say that the work is done, you have already learned in the previous grade that work is said to be done only when some force is applied on an object and that object is getting displaced. Here in this picture you can see that the man is pulling the cart. That means he is using his force to pull this cart. And so the force is applied by him and the cart is getting displaced. That means he has done some amount of work. Fine. So work done by a force acting on an object is nothing but the product of the magnitude of force and displacement of the object in the direction of force. I'll repeat, when do we say that the work is done? We say that the work is done when a force acting on an object is the product of the magnitude of the force applied by an object to displace another object. So mathematically we can speak that work is nothing but force into displacement. This you have already studied in standard 8. Fine. Now, let us see little ahead. Can you recall what are the different types of forces you have learned? Let me show you some pictures here. Here you can see a picture of a man lifting some dumbbells. Fine. So, what can you say about this type of work? Sorry, this type of force. This, you are right, it is a type of muscular force. Next, you can see a person is pulling the box. Okay, so he is also applying some amount of force in pulling this object, pushing this object. That means he is, coming across this frictional force. So, here there is a frictional force. Next, you can see that apple is falling on the, you know, from the tree. Do you know what type of a force it is? Yes, you're right. It is a type of, it is a gravitational force. You can see in this picture that there are two magnets, and magnets, two unlike poles are brought together, and you can see when the unlike poles are brought together, the magnet is getting pushed. So this is nothing but a magnetic force. Then you have already studied about another force called as static electric force. In this you can see a balloon is getting rubbed by the cloth, and when it is brought near the tap, you know, the water is going, you know, towards the balloon. Fine. So these are all different types of forces what you have learned in the previous grade. The muscular force and the frictional force are called as contact forces, because, you know, the object is coming in contact with the person who is applying the force. And in these three cases, wherein the two objects are not coming into contact, so they are also called as non-contact forces. So this you have already studied in standard 8. Fine. So now let us move little ahead and find out. No, let's see ahead. Now Mahesh wants to displace, you can see the picture, this one is Mahesh, and he is pushing the wooden block from point A to point B, fine, along the horizontal surface. Now to do so, he is applying some amount of force. Can you tell which type of force did he apply to perform this task? You are right. He is applying his muscular force. While applying force F, did he use all the energy to pull this box, or maybe to accelerate this box? Yes? Yes. He has used some amount of energy to pull this box to overcome the frictional force. Fine. So where is that remaining amount of energy which is used? It is used not to overcome frictional force. Fine. So first one to tell is that he is, you know, using his muscular force. Second, he is, you know, overcoming the frictional force. Next. So now that you have learned about, you know, what is work with respect to force and displacement, let us now quickly move ahead. Now let us study the work in detail. More about work. Now you have already learned how to calculate the work done on an object when the displacement is in the direction of applied force. What does this mean? You can see that a boy is pulling, you know, pushing the cart, and you can see he is applying his muscular force to push this cart. If you see, the force is in this direction as well as the displacement also in the same direction. Okay, the force and the displacement are in the same direction. Okay, I don't know whether you can see or not, both of them are in the same direction. So you have learned that the work can be calculated when the force and displacement are in the same direction. But if the displacement is not in the direction of the applied force, then how do we calculate the amount of work done? So let me show you some pictures here. Here two events are depicted in these two pictures. In the first event, a man is pulling a cart with a girl. And in the second, you can see that a bigger car is towing the smaller car. Fine. What do you think? Are the directions of force applied, direction of force applied, and the displacement are in the same direction, or are they different? You can see the direction of force in this first picture, and the displacement is like this. Fine. In the second picture also, the direction of force is this way, and the displacement is along the horizontal direction. So that in both the cases you can find that the direction of force and the displacement are not in the same direction. So let us see how to calculate work done in such cases when force and displacement are not in the same direction. For this, let us consider the first case. When a man is pulling the cart, force is applied along the direction of the string. You can see that he is pulling this cart and this is the string which he is using to pull this cart. You can see that the force applied is in the direction of the string. Fine, but if you see that this cart will be moving in this manner, that means the displacement of this cart is along the horizontal surface. Fine. That is, the cart is displaced along the horizontal direction. So in this case, in order to calculate the work done, we have to convert the applied force into the direction of displacement. So in this example, let F be the applied force. Fine. Let F1 be the force acting. Okay, let F be the force and applied force, whereas let F1 be the force acting along the direction of displacement. I hope so. Whatever I said, you have understood. What I said, I will repeat. In this example, let F be the force, applied force, and F1 be the force along the direction of displacement of the cart. Fine. So thus we can say that work is equal to force acting along the direction of displacement. Force acting along the direction of displacement according to the definition. So here the force acting along the direction of displacement, so displacement is along the horizontal surface, and horizontal surface, already I told you that it is F1. So therefore we can say in this work, over here the work done is equal to force acting along the direction of displacement. That force is F1, I have already told you, right? So therefore the formula becomes W is equal to F1 into S, where S is the displacement. This is equation number 1. Okay, now here you can see that the applied force is along, in this manner, whereas the component F1 is along the direction of displacement. Fine. Then it is this force F is making an angle with the F1. Therefore, let that angle be theta. I hope so you have learned, this names theta, alpha, beta. Fine. So in geometry, you will learn about this. You might have learned also that let this angle be theta, which is made by F with F1. Fine. So you can see that let us now try to draw. So to find out the component F along the direction of displacement, fine, that is F1. Okay. So to find out the component of F along the direction of displacement, that is F1, let us draw a perpendicular. Fine. You can see that I have drawn now one perpendicular here from F to F1. So now from the right angle triangle, now you can see that it has made one right angle triangle here. Fine. Now from this right angle triangle so formed, let us find out the component F1 of the applied force F, which is acting along the horizontal direction. So let us find out F1, okay, which is the component of F acting along the horizontal direction using trigonometry. Now this year, I think so, you are going to learn about trigonometry in geometry. Fine. So certain things you will have to, you know, look into the geometry textbook when you are going to learn about trigonometry. Fine. So here you can to find out this. There are, you know, certain trigonometric ratios called as sine theta, cos theta, tan theta, sec theta, cosec theta, and cot theta. Fine. So sine theta is opposite side upon hypotenuse, whereas cos theta is equal to base upon hypotenuse. Now, what did I say? Cos theta, which is the second trigonometric ratio, cos theta, the formula of cos theta is base upon hypotenuse. And here we need to find out F1. Therefore, we need to use this formula by using both these components, that is F1 as well as F. That means the best formula to find out F1 is cos theta. Okay, so let's see. Cos theta is nothing but formula is base. This is called as the base. This is called as opposite side. This is called as hypotenuse of the right triangle. So we are using the formula cos theta is equal to base upon hypotenuse. Fine. And here base is nothing but F1 and hypotenuse is F. Fine. So the formula becomes now F1 is equal to F1 upon F. So we can say by cross multiplying we can find out what is F1 now. Okay, F1 upon F, if you just, you know, cross multiply, you will find that F1 is equal to F into cos theta. So the formula becomes F1 is equal to F into cos theta. Now that we have got what is F1, let us now substitute the value of F1 in equation number 1. Fine. So, once we substitute in equation number 1, we are getting the formula as FW is equal to F dot cos theta dot S. Okay. So, F is the force, cos theta is the angle, and S is the displacement. Fine. This is the formula for finding out the work when work is the displacement is not in the direction of the force. Fine. So this is regarding the formula for finding out when the force and displacement are not in the same direction. So W is equal to F into cos theta into displacement. Fine. So now the formula becomes W is equal to F S cos theta. Next, you can see that, you know, I have placed an angle here. Now you can see you have learned in standard 6 about the different types of angle. Do you know what type of angle is this? This is the zero angle, wherein you can see one ray like this, another ray on above that. That means it is making zero angle. Let us find out when the, you know, force is along the component F1. What can be the work done? How much is the work done? So for that we will have to use this trigonometric ratio. So that's why I've placed this picture here. You can see cos theta, sin theta, tan theta, cos, cosec, sec, and cot. So we need only cos theta. So cos of 0, let us find out cos of 0 is 1. So when cos of 0 is 1, when we substitute in the formula Fs cos theta, so W is equal to F into S into 1. So when we substitute, the answer we are getting W is equal to Fs. Fine. So you can see that at 0 degree cos theta is 1, W becomes F into S. When we substitute the value of theta as 0 degree, we are getting this formula. And what we can conclude from this? We can conclude that here the positive work is done. Okay, when the force and displacement are in the same direction, we say that the work done is positive. And when it is in the same direction, that means the angle over here will be 0 degree. Let us see the next case. When the angle is 90 degree, that means the force F is perpendicular to the displacement. Fine, that is F1. So in this case, the angle is 90 degree. So let us see for 90 degree, cos 90 degree, what is the value? So cos of 90 degree when we go, it is 0 here. You can see it is 0. So cos of 90 is 0. So when we substitute in the formula, W is equal to Fs cos 90 degree, we get W is equal to F into S into 0. So F into S into 0 becomes 0. So that means when the force and displacement are at right angle to each other, that means perpendicular to each other, zero work is done. So this is the conclusion. You can see over here that when the cos of 90 degree is 0, work done is also 0. That means when both of them are perpendicular to each other, work done will be 0. Now let us see when the angle is 180 degree. That means the force and displacement are in the opposite direction. Okay, they are in the opposite direction. So let's see what happens at that time. So you can see that this angle is 180 degree or a linear angle. So force is in this direction and the displacement is in this direction. So what sort of work is done in this case? So we can see that it is 180 degree, cos of 180 degree is minus 1. So when we substitute in the formula, W is equal to F into S into cos of 180 degree, it will be equal to F into S into minus 1. So F into S into minus 1 becomes minus Fs. So we can say that it is doing negative work. So 180 degree is when the cos theta is 180 degree and it is minus 1, we can say the formula becomes W is equal to minus Fs and work done in this case is negative. Fine. So this is regarding work done when the force and displacement are not in the same direction. Fine. And what type of work it is, whether it is a positive work when force and displacement are in the same direction, we say that the work done is positive and at that time angle is 0 degree. Whereas when the force is perpendicular to the displacement, then we say that the work done is 0. Whereas when the work, force and displacement are in the opposite direction, then we can say that the work done is negative. Fine. So in the next video, we will learn about what is meant by, what are the units of work. Till then, bye. Good night.